Hi, my name is Mr. Codilla, and today I'm going to show you how to do some of the advanced features with an adaptive Google form, or what's sometimes referred to as a logic branching form. And just to reference a video prior to that, if you go down to a question, it's this function right here. Go to section based on answer. But I'm going to show you a typical example of what I have in my classroom. First, of course, this is a Google form that I formatted for one of my classes, so it has a title right up here at the top. A lot of times I have a learning goal right here. So as I often tell my students, this is not just a quiz or another test. This is actually how I deliver many of my lessons. So students come to my classroom, they open up our Schoology updates, and they'll see a Google Form link. They fill in their last name, their first name, they have a drop down for their box. I'm just going to show you the behind the scenes of this Google Form. I'll actually show you the live version of it as well. So this is one that I recently used. You'll see that there's no like quiz in or quiz questions and answers and things like that. It's primarily just content delivery right here, just the lesson delivery. So we come down here to a graphic that I made in Google Slides, and this is a question, you know, which is the safest way to use the cutter tool. Now, what's interesting about this is, just as I referenced earlier, this is a go-to section based on answer question. So when a student looks at this and they're learning our lesson, they're going through all the lesson goal, they're looking at this goal or this question and they're asking themselves, okay, you know, what do I need to do here? And if they get it wrong, they'll go to section two. If they get it right, they go to section three. Pretty simple as that. And this saves me a lot of teaching time, a lot of remediation. Also gives me very valuable data, and we'll look at it a little bit later as well. So here's section two. If they didn't get that question right, it goes to this section, and it teaches them. And I have another graphic here. This one says, this is the correct way, this is the incorrect way. And right here it says, which direction should the you point the cutter at all times? So it kind of asks, you know, the same question, just in a different way. It gives them more help, gives them a little bit more instruction as well. Now, I just have this going to the next section. If they got it wrong, you could actually have them go on to another section just to kind of keep teaching them and keep doing that remediation if you need to. Here's the third section, the scratchboard drawing. Again, this is more instruction assessment for learning. So it's instruction actually through question format many times. So I'm asking this question again, just over and over again, tool safety for this particular learning goal. Now, it also has a video. This video doesn't have anything to do directly with just this question. It actually covers it, but there's so much more. This is lesson delivery again. So I come down, I have more, after they watch this video, I have more examples that I put on and some more instructions just quickly made in Google Slides graphics. I mean, this was nothing like Photoshop or anything like that. And I added some very clear examples, some zoomed in graphics here. And then when they get to the end, as a little reminder, I will also say this. When I come up to the settings, so once they submit this in my classroom, I'm constantly keeping my students busy. So they're constantly engaged. So I come up here to the little cog here, the settings, and I go over to presentation. And when they're done, it'll give them a confirmation message. It isn't just your standard, you know, thank you for submitting your answer type message. It actually has instructions for the next step or next series of steps. So here's some of the things that they could be doing for the next step. So that is the first. Now the second one I'll be looking at is this Google form right here. And you see that this is actually a little bit more elaborate. This is our scratchboard drawing final. So this actually has due dates. I put due dates in the Google form so students know exactly where this is at. I also post them on Schoology. Comes down here and I have my learning goal. So again, this isn't just a quiz or a test. This is actually a lesson delivery method that I use many times. Has the definition of it. Again, last name, first name, hour in a drop-down menu. It's got hashing, you know, then it goes again, like if they got it, that this question wrong, it would go to the try again section, and it teaches them, shows them a graphic, and it asks them again, you know, what is hashing, which option is hashing, and then it gives us additional instruction with the value scale. This could be done in many different ways. I think of this more as like a digital packet, you know, like, you know, teachers would hand out like worksheet packets. This is a digital packet. So this is kind of like self-assessment. I gave them a scale here, and then I'm asking them in their drawing, what values do you have? in there. And this is a checkbox, not a drop-down menu or multiple choice, so they can click all the different values that they have. You can do this in many different ways. I can see this like in lab, like science labs or writing assignments. You can have criteria. Did you get the setting? Did you get your plot? Did you get your characters? Did you do this in the lab? Did you, go through all these steps? And they can just checkbox all these things. Again, this is giving me a lot of data. We'll take a look at it a little bit later too. Again, I got some more definitions, some more helps. I also put examples in here too, the finished example. What kind of quality are we aiming for? So here's the next section as well. It says, if you need more help, there's a little bit more remediation. This is a video that I showed them in a previous Google form, but actually I put it again in this Google form too. So just in case they need a little bit more help that particular day, they can go to this. They can skip it too. I often tell my students that, again, this is not a quiz, not a test. So if you don't need this video, you can skip it. But do notice that I did put some very clear reminders in here. Rewatch, skip back, skip ahead, and pause as needed. So they can use that video as a resource. I keep my videos relatively short when in my lessons. So, and then I like this section down here. I go down to think you're finished, question mark. And then I have them go through a self-assessment in their project. I have them ask themselves these questions, yes or no. Did they get all these things? Going through all this. And then they get down to, this is basically our rubric right here, so they can grade themselves. They get to the end. And when they get to the end, it says, after the scratchboard drawing, they have some very easy steps to go through right here. And here in these links, these are actually hyperlinks. So in the live form, you'll see here in a moment, these are actually live links. So the Google form actually will do links that they can just click on. It says complete the entire form, so forth and so on. And again, I click on this cog, go to presentations, and I have those links again over here. So if they do go ahead and submit the form, they don't have to go back through the form and try to get to those links again. So let me go ahead and show you the live form. I'll go through this real quick. Scratchboard drawing, I'm just going to type in a few answers here. Just go through this real quick. What is hatching? It is using lines to create values. So if I had got it wrong, actually I'll go ahead and answer it wrong, just so you can see what it looks like when they get it wrong. Click next. Try again. So which option is hatching? I'll get it right this time. Click next. Now it moves on through this lesson. I can start clicking through. I can start assessing my drawing. This could go for many different things, and they go, okay, I have these values. Maybe I need to work on these values or whatever they need to do. Then go, okay, and here's the example, the quality we're looking for. Click next. If I need more help, they're going, okay, so I need more help to get to that type of quality. Here's my video. I can click on that and play this. Here's the video, and they can pause. And they can go forward. And it has that example that was actually mentioned and how I created that. And they can click next. Then they go through this and basically self-assess. Then go through here and grade themselves. Now notice it does say it requires an answer for each question. And again, there's those links, there's the instructions, so they can keep going. They can click on these links here, they can submit it, and then they still have those instructions right there on the final page, and then go ahead and click on the next set of instructions or the next thing that they need to move on to. Now, one thing that I will remind you of is that when you actually send this, you want to go ahead and get this link here. If you're doing this in Schoology, it's kind of tricky. You want to actually go to this link, come up here, copy it, and then put it in Schoology. For some reason, a lot of times, if you just copy it here and try to put it in Schoology, it's not a live link. It doesn't show up in blue and underlined and be underlined. It's just kind of like a dead gray link. So you actually want to come up here and copy this URL. That really helps you out when you put it into Schoology.